What do you recommend?
Beer.
We'll have five of those, please. Four of those and a tap water.
What? Have you ever had a night so special you wanted to have it all over again? Well, except the morning after bit. That's the premise behind The World's End, the new and third film from Simon Pegg, Nick Frost and director Edgar Wright, the team behind Hot Fuzz and Shaun of the Dead.
And it'll be just like it always was, except this time we're going to finish this thing once and for all.
This thing being a pub crawl of epic proportions that's rudely interrupted by the discovery that the town is, well, not quite the same as it used to be.
In my worst pub crawl event, I ended up being run over by a car whilst stark naked. In this film, the outcome of the pub crawl is decidedly more apocalyptic as it brought up a few dusty memories of uni days for you guys.
What?
I didn't go to uni. I left school at 15.
Wait a minute. The guy said he got run over by a car naked.
It happened.
I rolled off the bonnet of a 1989 Corolla like water off a duck's back, and I kept running like a hero.
Good on you.
Like a drunk Superman hero.
What was it you saw in the morning?
Yeah, bruises all up and down my legs.
Nice.
But I sort of made the pub crawl.
Feels good though,
I
right?
I finished. I completed.
A lot of these events are sort of life-threatening quests for a lot of guys, and ours takes that to its logical conclusion.
There is some epic drinking in this film, but I'm assuming that you do use some kind of stunt drink.
Yeah, we're not sucking down real piss. It's essentially water, caramelized water, so it looks like lager, and then we have like a foamy top which we made from like a cream soda.
Is that hard to slam down? I can't imagine that'd be fun. You don't drink something.
It's not.
Why would you want to drink 12 pints of lager when you can drink 12 pints of water?
Because it would improve your acting, in my example.
This is the key. When you drink, like, you think your acting improves, you think your humor improves, you think you're a better person when you have a drink, but you're not. Because when you think you're being charming and funny,
leave a light on, good lady, for the...
Pegg's character, Gary King, is a reckless rock and roll man-child, hell-bent on reliving his past glories.
Gary is a dick from the beginning. He's crippled by his dickness. He's crippled by his dick. He's a cripple dick.
That's going to be the grab that makes it on the promo.
Gary, are you serious? I haven't seen you in 20 years. Do you really think I'm going to have sex with you in the ladies' toilet?
Well, the disabled is out of order.
Obviously, Newton Haven has some relevance to everyone's journey going back to their hometowns. Is there some of your own hometowns in Newton Haven, do you think?
Yeah, well, it sort of was inspired a little bit by me trying to do a pub crawl in my hometown when I was 19, which went very badly. So it's always a sort of bittersweet experience when you realise that your hometown is changing without you there. And that's really where the idea for the movie started to sort of gel, is like one character wants to turn back the clock and be a teenager again, and yet the sort of the town is kind of like sort of insidiously like changing into something else.
Moving on, I've been told, Simon, that you're the only actor to have appeared in all three Star Wars, Star Trek and Doctor Who franchises. Confirm or deny, have you also been a part of Coldplay?
I have, yeah. I'm the fifth member. Play the harmonica. A blues harp, usually in G. Played it in 2001 at V2001. Played it at the Emirates Stadium, played it at the O2 Arena in London to 18,000 people.
And is it rock and roll backstage for those guys, or is it serious business?
Well, I think the level of serious business is measured by their success. You know, they do take it seriously. They don't just swig vodka and bang people willy-nilly backstage.
All right, so robots, zombies, a village mystery murder. What could be next for you two? Could it be another season of Spaced?
I think there's probably more chance of me pooping out Donald Sutherland at this precise moment.
Which is what we're gonna
be pooping out Donald Sutherland. Sutherland.
Is that the new project?
Yeah. It's like being John Malkovich.
Is it a breech birth?
I hope he comes out sideways for shits and giggles. Literally.
More shits, those and giggles.